All right, welcome back to another episode of I Don't Know What I'm Doing. Welcome back to the Chop Shop. So, I've got the rear third of the Miata chopped off. That way I can still use the mounting points for the subframe and the suspension. I can skin this, take the frame, and just weld it in the truck. So today, I need to repeat that process for the front. That way, again, so I have something to bolt the subframe and suspension components to. Then once that's done, this middle section can get recycled. So let's get to it. So the front and the rear thirds are off of the car. That's pretty much it. That's all I need to get out of this car for what I need for the truck. I already have all the front subframe suspension bits out, as well as the rear. Those are stored away right now. What I need to do next is, I'm not entirely too sure what I'm going to do with this. Because all of this can just get recycled. But cutting all this up into little pieces, that's easier said than done. Because you have a lot of, you know, various sections to go through. It's not just a straight shot like, oh, you know, we'll just go down, you know, this way or down the middle and cut it in half. Well, it would take quite a bit of time. It would be nice to just take it to the metal recycling place, just as one unit. Now, I currently don't have a way to do that unless I register the truck, which it does run and drive, so that's an option. And I do want that truck registered so I can drive it around once it's built and work out bugs that way, just, you know, daily driving it before I have to go drive it on a racetrack. It would be nice to have all that stuff sorted before we get there. So I guess that'll be the next modification for the truck, getting it registered. And then just loading this up in the bed and all the other scrap metal and recycling it and getting a few bucks out of that to put towards the project.
What?
so I've got all the fat trimmed off the rear frame rails, and what I have left is just the frame rails with the mounting points for the subframe, as well as the strut. And here's all the excess material that I took off the rear third section of the car, and all this can go get recycled. Okay, real quick, I just found something awesome. Money! So it looks like 95 cents total there that I get to use in the budget. More money! This is like money. This is all kinds of hardware that I don't have to pay for now. I'd like to pull the seat out of the car and keep it. Not really to sell, just to hold on to it. It would make for kind of a cool garage seat. It looks like a couple owners ago, the person that crashed it, tried to retrieve it. They removed the front two bolts and then realized it wouldn't slide forward because it had been, the rail here had been pushed in, locking the seat, locking it in. So they couldn't get the rear two bolts out. So I'm bending this back, hopefully so I can slide the seat forward and then pull out the last two bolts. Well, that's the plan anyway. A lot of this is pulled back already, but it's just not out enough. Come on, man. Get out of here. Okay, after a lot of heavy persuasion, I've got the seat moved forward about 2 inches, enough where I can feel the bolt, the one bolt that's holding the seat in. So hopefully I can get a wrench in there to get it out. Okay, one more bolt for real this time. Seat. Okay, cool. That's pretty much all I plan on taking out of this car. And you know what? I didn't initially plan on doing this part today, but the only thing left that I have to do on this car is cut the cabin in half and throw it in the bed of the truck. And that's it. And then I can put the Mustang back in the garage, finally. So I guess I'll just get on with that. I'm gonna see what I can do with a Sawzall first, because I'm also gonna have to go through the frame rail. And if I can just sit through with this, cool. If not, then I'll do some plasma cutting. Like butter. Poor blade. Well, this blade's done. Oh, so close too. I got more. We're good. There we go. Now we just zip zip and that's it. Aw. Don't do that.
straight. Okay, I'm sorry, I forgot to turn the microphone on for that scene. But instead of plasma cutting it, I just did that. Then it worked. Ta-da! So the tailgate doesn't open, that's why I had to load everything the way I did. But it's done, the Miata is gone, it's chopped up, I got what I need, and the scraps are in the truck. So now it's time to clean the garage and have a beer. So that's it for this vlog. If you haven't lately, go check out the website. Or if you don't know that we have a website, it's featuredgarage.com. Go check it out. We primarily write articles about cars in our area. We are also on, you know, the social medias, the Facebooks, the Instagrams, and here, the YouTubes. So yeah, that's it. Until the next article or the next vlog, see ya.